The question, with COVID rates dropping, do you think we'll be able to have a normal summer of concerts and travel? And are there legal risks for venues and businesses that open all the way back up right away? Okay, thank you, Jeanette. And that's a good question.
Yeah, I'd like to respond to that. I think it's a very timely question. Just this morning, the CDC just came out with some new guidelines for individuals that have been vaccinated. And I think a lot of people, I hear this all the time, if we got vaccinated, what's the point? If it doesn't change anything we can do or the way we conduct ourselves. And I think the CDC just needed to wait to watch the vaccinations actually have an effect. And they said they're seeing that this morning. And so what the change was, if you're vaccinated now, they're saying if you're at outdoor events and you're vaccinated, you do not need to wear a mask. They're also saying that if you're in a household where all the adults have been vaccinated, you do not need to wear a mask. That's very important when it comes to your grandparents who maybe haven't been able to visit because of health concerns. Now, if they've been vaccinated and you're in a family household where everyone but the kids have been vaccinated, no mask required, they're saying you're free to get together. So I think we will have a normal summer. I know the president spoke last night and said that he's very hopeful that we can have a great 4th of July and celebrate in a normal 4th of July style. So hopefully things open back up, they continue on the trend that they're on, and everyone go get vaccinated because you get all kinds of rights and to act more normal once you do. So
I know I'm looking forward to it. I have a few weeks to go before I can, qualified to get the shot, actually, because I had COVID. So I'll make my 90-day mark, I guess, when it's safer for me to have that vaccination. So yay. And yeah, you two both have had your vaccinations, right?
That's correct.
Yes. Yeah. And I went to an outdoor concert this past weekend at Renaissance, a great concert with three or four bands. Now, there were some differences. They took your temperature before you went in, and they had people socially distanced, and you brought a block or a table. But a great afternoon and night of music kind of made me feel, somewhat normal going back to when we had no restrictions, where we were wall to wall with people. And we just thought that was normal. Was not normal anymore. Yeah. The new normal is you're going to have to take some measures. And some of these things that we've done, I think are going to carry over in the future, and they're not necessarily bad. I mean, I think taking the temperature every morning at school is a good thing. That's it's a prevented thing. A lot of kids that were probably shouldn't have been there in the first place from getting into school and getting other people sick, whether it's COVID or even the flu. And so I've seen, in my family, people have been healthier. I've seen a lot of other people be healthier in the past year or so outside of COVID.
Yeah. And I'd like to add on, I think part of that question was about businesses and what liability they may have. And so what you're going to see is that the businesses are going to try to follow the guidelines that exist in your state and federally. If you'll notice right now, so our state loosened up restrictions on the mask earlier than a lot of other states, I believe. And I know that our vaccines were offered at higher levels or to a larger population quicker than most states. However, you'll notice that. So if you go into a local restaurant, what we might call a mom and pop restaurant, there might not be a mask requirement because there's no state mask requirement. However, if you go into a national chain restaurant, they're going to require it because the national mandate is still that the mask be there. So those are the differences you're going to see between local restaurants. And I could say that about retailers as too. You go into a Walmart or, you go into another national retailer versus a local retailer, you're going to see them acting more like what the national CDC is requiring versus a local retailer who's just adhering to the state's guidelines. But you're going to find that all of them are going to slowly ease up as both the state continues to ease up and the federal guidelines, the CDC continue to ease up. So,